I just want to say thank you very much to each and every one of you. A lot of you, including Ken and Dr. Maloki, believe it or not, have really been an inspiration and a tremendous help to me. A lot of you have given up of your time and your money. And so I just wanted to come back this morning and say thank you very much. Tuesday morning breakfast will always be special to me because it is a source of inspiration, information, and as well as a connectivity to our heritage here in the city of Charlotte. So as I make this transition to Raleigh in a real personal way with living arrangements and being away from my family, which is a transition for me, which I just want you guys to be mindful of, because I am still a husband and a dad. I have a 2-year-old, and she's 7. So I make no bones about it. If I need to come home during the middle of the week, I'm going to check on my baby.
All right.
Because she is my responsibility first. And I learned that here as it relates to all of the many issues that we're faced with in our community. So again, I just want you to know, as I make this transition, I take the Tuesday morning breakfast with me. And thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I think we all need to get ready for a new reality.
Yes.
The Republicans have taken control of the governor's mansion and both houses of government, the House and the Senate, in addition to the state Supreme Court. So I think you can really anticipate some very socially conservative public policies and a pro-business climate in our state. But look out for school vouchers. Look out for voter ID. Look out for those things that they tried to push forward that Governor Perdue vetoed. They have no backstop. So one of the things that, real quick, Ms. Sarah, that I'm hoping to do that we, and I think we can improve upon from being legislators from Mecklenburg, from Raleigh to Charlotte, is to keep you guys informed about what's going to happen and then how that's going to impact your life. Because I do believe it's going to be real. Because they have an agenda and they make no bones about it. They will push forward through their agenda, and you know, God bless you and God bless us all. Let me give you one quick example of what's going on in our state right now, and it's going to impact us in a major way here in Charlotte, are those business centers or sweepstakes. Currently, right now, they are not regulated. And they are not being taxed. They are popping up all over our community. Well, they have, already popped up all over our community. And they're in our convenience stores in these back rooms by the bathroom. They're playing these video slots. And I learned last night, they're paying out cash in addition to gift cards. And so the state tried to stop it. And so it was upheld in a lower and in the appellate court. Right now, it is in the state Supreme Court. And they're very confident, y'all, that it's going to pass the state Supreme Court, that they're willing to come to us as legislators and saying, hey, we want you to regulate us and tax us. So it seems like it's going to be here to stay. So I just want you to be mindful of the impact that that's going to have on our community. And as Ms. Mayfield, through zoning, can do what they can do locally. But I just want y'all to know, those are the kinds of incremental, in my opinion, negative impacts that slowly deteriorate and erode our community if we don't do something about it, as it relates to what this young lady's trying to do with Project Lift. Those are those little foxes That's in our right. community that we have to be on guard against to protect our babies so that they won't get hooked on this video gambling. That is very real, because I'm aware of somebody who goes there 3 times a week looking for a win. So that's just one other piece. And Ken, you're absolutely correct, Ms. Sarah. My personality says I want to work with everybody who wants to work with us and make sure that they're going to do what's in the best interest of our community and not just make a buck off of us. That's right.